Why does what happens? Why does it happen?
According to his vocation, living a chaste, incontinent life, a life of celibacy, and to give up the sexual immorality. He was inspired by the model of St. Anthony, the desert monk, who lived such a radical ascetic life. And so Augustine's whole transformation was around the moral question of the impotence of his will without grace, but the empowerment of his will by grace to live the life of charity. Now,
does it matter if I confess my mind to it and pour in a lesson?
Predestination, he definitely teaches. But so does the Catholic faith. Predestination is a Catholic doctrine, not a uniquely Reformed doctrine. The Calvinists, however, put a unique spin on predestination. The Calvinist view is that, first of all, the predestined can know with infallible certainty in this life that they are predestined.
Why does what happens happen? Did it really need to be the way it happens, or is destiny in a twin or triple breach? If you reach something that can't be teached or taught, it's distraught, it's what you rot.
And that Augustine never taught, and that the Catholic Church doesn't teach. Secondly, for the Reformed or Protestant Christian, predestination, well, not all Protestants, but for the Reformed, predestination and regeneration are coextensive. In other words, the Calvinist believes that once a man has been regenerated by grace, he will necessarily persevere and be saved. Teaches that regeneration and predestination are not coextensive. And so a person could be regenerated by grace, but could walk away from that grace and be lost. And that, of course, accords precisely with the teaching of sacred scripture. St. Paul says, I'll buffet my body and make it my slave, lest, having preached to others, I myself might be disqualified. Where St. Peter says in his second epistle, it better to never have entered the way of righteousness than to have entered and then turn away. Or the book of Hebrews chapter 6, it says, if we fall away, we crucifying Son of God all over again, etc., etc., etc. So the consistent teaching of the New Testament is that those who have tasted the life of grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit must consciously persevere in the life of grace, actively cooperate, and there is a live possibility that they might step away from the life of grace and be lost.
Is there a purpose beyond what you swerve with, beyond that odd circus?
Saved when you persevered to the end and been saved by clinging to Christ. I wrote a little article you might find interesting.